This is another lecture on moving average, on reasons of being of moving average, and on ways to evaluate quality of a forecasting technique like 1 period moving average, 2 period moving average, 3 period moving average. And so I have this set of data. Usually I get my data in a random form, but to avoid your confusion during discussion, I usually copy them and paste them by value. I will consider column D as my input data, but when I complete my discussion, again, I set it back to these changing numbers, and I show how the outputs are changed based on the changes in input. But for the time being, we keep them fixed. I have these 12 pieces of data, and I want to forecast for the next period. On extreme right, I may be very conservative and take into account all numbers. For example, if these are 12 individuals, each having an idea, I combine all ideas and I use it as my forecast. It's average of these numbers. And lock it because I'm going to copy it down. And therefore, this will be my forecast for the next period. Now I should have a base point. How could I find it out if this average is a better method or there are some other methods which are better than this? That baseline is math. I will find the difference between actual and forecast. And I will select a method for which this difference is minimal. But here, if I add all differences, the summation is zero. Why? Because negative numbers and positive numbers cross each other out. However, a negative number is as bad as a positive number. A negative deviation is as bad as a positive deviation. Positive deviation is as bad as a negative deviation. Therefore, I should ignore this sign. Both positive and negative are not good. I put an absolute value in front of this difference, and that will drop the negative sign. Now if I go here and if I compute the average of these gaps, the average is around 11, and that is what I call it mean absolute deviation. Now if I come out with another technique with lower math, that technique is perhaps better than average. If I can't, then I should stay with averages. Average was on the extreme right. On the extreme left, I may say forecast for next period is equal to actual for this period. Therefore, I ignore everything except the last period. I ignore whatever all other people say except what the last person who comes in and think. I just stay on what the last person says. Here, forecast for next period is equal to actual for this period. This is called naive technique or 1 period moving average. Under this procedure, my forecast for the next period would be 66. Under average is 31. This one takes into account all numbers. This one takes into account the last number. Now I should find it out if this one is better or this one. Point of departure is whether mad of average is better or mad of 1 period moving average. Equal to actual minus forecast with absolute value. That is what I have. And I also compute the average of these gaps. And that is 9 compared to 10. But when I am comparing two techniques with each other, I should compare them over the same number of periods. Because here for 1 period moving average or naive technique, my first piece of data is for period 2. Therefore, this MAD should also be computed starting from period 2, ending with period 12. MAD for average, MAD for 1 period moving average, and here average is dominated by 1 period moving average. Average, 1 period moving average, both over the same number of periods, and this one is better than this. If I change my data, sometimes average may be better. Yeah, here average is better. For this data, 1 period moving average is better. But maybe 2 period moving average is even better than 1 period moving average. 3 period moving average may be better than 1 or 2 period moving average and better than average. I may go here and I may compute 2 period and 3 period moving average. Okay, so for 2 period moving average, I compute average of period 1 and 2 and set it as my forecast for period 3. So I go to period 3 and I type equal to average of period 1 and 2. And then I copy it down. For period 4, I go here and I say equal to average of period 1, 2, and 3, and I set it as forecast for period 4. And then I copied it down. Now I have these 4 techniques. Because the first piece of data for the last technique is available in period 4, therefore MAD for all of them should be computed from period 4 to period 12, 4 to 12, 4 to 12, and 4 to 12. Now I have all my MADs for period 4 to 12, and I can compare them. And for this set of data, average provides a better forecast because MAD is smaller. If I change the data for this set of data, 1 period moving average or naive technique is better. Again, for this one, average is better. For this one, 3 period moving average is better. 2 period moving average is better. To put that best here or there, equal to minimum of these numbers. But I have made the color of the font white, therefore we cannot see it. And over here, if what you see here is equal to the minimum, which is over there, type best. Otherwise, type nothing. And then I have copied it this way. Besides MAD, we also have another technique to compare several forecasting methods. Instead of absolute value to drop the sign, we find the gap between actual and forecast. We squared. Square also drops the sign. That's it. Actual and forecast and square and copy it down. The gap between actual and forecast and square. Average, average, and average. And the same as before, the one which is smaller is better. When we compute squared, those numbers where the gap between actual and forecast are large will have much more impact on defining which method is better. Here, it does not allow very big gaps between actual and forecast because it makes it squared, and that square makes the result maybe larger than the others. However, as we see, for this set of data, both average of squares and MAD will give the same results. Here they give the same results, but here MAD says average is better, while mean square method says 3-period moving average is better. Here both say 2-period is better, 1-period is better, average is better, 2-period better, 2-period better, 3 better, 3, 1, 1. But again here, 2-period is better, and this one says 1-period is better. They will not always reach the same results. Now, let us draw these graphs. Here I have periods and actual data. Insert. Scatter graph, insert this one. This is our actual data, which is changing, all right? Now I'll go, and I'll get average, copy, paste. That is over there, was added to my graph. That was average, copy, click here, paste. This is 1-period moving average. Copy, click here, paste. 2-period moving average. Copy, click here, and paste. That is 3-period moving average. And these numbers are changing. Add chart element and add legend at the bottom. So these are our data. Thank you very much for your patience.